Hey everyone, it's Dan here from PixelFix and welcome to my channel. This episode is part of my Laravel 9 API development course, and in this course we will cover the most frequently used features of Laravel with regards to API development. We will also cover some more advanced features which might not be so frequently used, but it will be good to know how and when to use them. And in this episode we'll be implementing a login mechanism using JWT tokens and cookies. Alright, so let's create our login controller. We would also need a login request. So let's create that. Seems like I forgot to place the login controller inside our auth folder. So let's move that and let's just update our namespace and then import our base controller. Okay, so now let's configure our login request. Change that to true because we're not going to use the form request to do authorization, and let's clear out all these block. Say that returns a boolean and that will return an array. Alright, so for our login we will require our email address, which would then need to be a required field. A required field, and it needs to be an email. And we'll also require a password, which would be required. And that should be it. Okay, so let's create our login method. So back to our login controller, we can say public function login, and then we can ask Laravel to inject our login request for us. Okay, now we can check whether the correct login details were provided by attempting to authenticate. Let's first extract the login details from the request. Credentials, and that would be, get that from the request and the validated method. Okay, then we can say if it's not authenticated attempt, and then we can pass in the email which we'll get from the credentials email, and the password from the credentials password. Okay, so if the login attempt fails, we want to return a response that says incorrect username or password, and we want to provide a response code, say HTTP response code of 422, which normally translate as unprocessable entity. Okay, let's save that and see if it works. If we head over to Postman, we would then be able to hit API /login and with the post request, and we should get I forgot to actually start up the server. Let's just do that quick. Okay, let's try this again. Okay, login controller does not exist. Oh, right, okay. So if we head back to the routes file, I forgot to import the login controller at the top. So let's save that, head back over to Postman, and let's try this again. And let's just change our headers. Accept and application JSON, and let's try this again, third time lucky. And there you'll see. Okay, so the email, the validation works. Email field is required, password field is required. Okay, so let's provide some details. Email, let's say, example.com, and the password would be, let's say, password. And now if we go, it should say status 200. So it means that our validation has worked and we've stopped at this stage after the login attempt has been made. Alright, so now that our login has been successful, we can generate a token and send that back as part of the response after login. So let's first create a token, or let's first get the user, because we would have access to the user now. Alright, and then we can say the decrypted token would be the user create token, and then when that's created we want to extract the plain text token. Okay, so now that we've got the decrypted token, we want to encrypt it. Encrypted token. And we can use Laravel's built-in crypt function. And we want to encrypt the decrypted token. Okay. Now we also want to generate our JWT token. JWT. Alright, so let's pull in our JWT and we want to encode our encrypted token. Okay, encrypted token, and we want to use our salt as the config, as basically our app key should be good enough to use this, so we can call it from the config helper app.key, and our third parameter would be the algorithm to use. In most cases you can use the HS256 algorithm, which should be sufficient for this case. Okay, so next let's generate our cookie. We'll just call the cookie equals, then we can use Laravel's cookie method, we'll give it a name, we'll just call it our JWT, and the value would then be the encrypted JWT token. Alright, so now we can return a response. We can say response. We don't need to give it a message. Oh yes, we can. We can return the JWT token as part of the response, and we can also say with cookie, and then provide the cookie we just created as part of the response. Okay, so let's go head over to Postman and see if it works. So we can use the same login credentials. We can send it. Okay, so it seems like, right, yeah. What I forgot to do was, if we head back over to VS Code, when you create a token, you need to give it a name as well. This can basically be anything you want it to be. It doesn't need to be unique. It can be basically anything. But personally, I like to use the user ID. All right, so let's head back over to Postman and let's try this again. All right, there we go. Now we've received our JWT token as part of the login request. And if we look at cookies, we'll see that the JWT has been given to us. And if we have a quick look at it, we can have a look, and it looks like it's exactly the same as within the response. Okay, so in order for us to utilize this JWT token, we'll need to intercept the request and check whether the cookie has been included in that request. So let's head over to VS Code, and we can do this by manipulating the authenticate middleware, which has already been provided for us. All right. So we need to overwrite the handle method. Okay, so we need to check whether the request does have a cookie called JWT, and we also want to assign that cookie or the value of the cookie to the JWT cookie. All right, and then we want to decode the JWT value, JWT decode, and we would provide the JWT cookie. We would then need to provide a new key. And this key would need to be imported at the top. Let's just say use Firebase/JWT/key. Okay, and we need to provide the salt, which we use to encode the key, which was then config app.key. Then our third parameter again would be the algorithm we used is HS256. Okay, so now that we've got the JWT decoded, we want to decrypt the token, which was inside the JWT. And we can use the crypt function again, decrypt the JWT decoded. Okay, now we've got the decrypted token, and in order for Laravel Sanctum to work, we need to add this decrypted token to the request headers. So headers set. We want to set the authorization, and we want to make it a bearer token. So in order to do that, we just add the decrypted token like so, and now we can continue to authenticate our request by calling the authenticate and then passing the request and the guards. And then after that, we can then return next request. Okay, so that is for overriding the handle method of the authentication middleware. Okay, so in order for us to test this, let's head over to the API routes file. And just for example's sake, we will protect the register route by adding a middleware that's called auth sanctum. All right, and that's it. So let's head over to Postman to have a look. Okay, so we've got our register route, which is now protected by the middleware. And as you can see, we've got an unauthenticated response, 401. So if we look at our cookies, we'll see we don't have the JWT token in our cookie. So let's go to the login route, localhost login. Let's provide some login information. Okay, and the password is password. So now we authenticated, we received our token, and if we go back to the register route, we can have a look. We'll see we've got the JWT token, and if we refresh now, we'll see that the form validation works, meaning that we have passed the authentication using the JWT token in the cookie. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I really hope this was informative. And remember, if you like this video, please hit that like button, smash and subscribe. And yeah, I'll see you in the next episode. Cheers. Bye-bye.